Hello everybody, this is Gustavo from copperhost.com, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to create a hosting account in WHM cPanel. Okay, first of all you must access your WHM panel. Afterwards you are going to go here to the search box and type account. You are going to scroll here and click create new account. Okay, so first of all we are going to scroll a little the screen. Here we will inform the domain name, so domainexample.com. This will be the hosted domain name. cPanel will delegate a username automatically. Okay, you must take note of this username. Here you are going to type a password and then I'm going to retype, confirm the password. Okay, you can also use the password generator if you prefer. It will generate very complicated passwords. Okay, but I'm going to use my own password. Here you may inform the client email address, so let's use client@hotmail.com, just an example. Here under package we can create predefined packages, or else we can just select options manually. To make things easier, I'm going to select manually. Okay, so we can just save this as a new package if we prefer, and let me just create. So first of all, disk space, let's give to this account 10 gigs. Okay, I'm going to keep the bandwidth unlimited. Okay, so I'm going to keep everything unlimited. Let's say you must limit the number of databases. I'm going to limit this to 5 databases, and here you can limit the parked and the domains. I'm going to limit to 5 domains here, for instance, for example. We can also perform a nice limitation of the hour limit for email, so that we can prevent this account doesn't send so many emails. So I'm going to keep here, let's say 200 hourly emails. Okay, and then we can limit here the maximum number of email failures. This is also important to avoid spamming. So in this example, I'm going to use here, let's say 50. Okay, so we can just save as a new package for you to use in the future, and then as you save as a new package, this package will appear here, so that you doesn't need to select again all the parameters. So I'm going to give the name as plan 1. Okay, and then I'm going to scroll down. Here you select if this account will have a dedicated IP or not. Okay, in this example I'm using the same IP as the main server. Here, shell access, if you wish your customer to be able to access the server by SSH, you can either select or deselect. The CJE access, I don't recommend changing, this is a default. Now you select the language. Okay, we are keeping in English. Now you can keep this as a reseller or a standard customer. By default I'm not selecting this. Okay, I'm just creating a standard account. Now some DNS options. I strongly recommend enabling SPF which will increase the delivery for your emails. It helps a lot. Okay. These are the DNS servers you must use in your domain registrar. After creating this account, you must go to your registrar, or else the company where you registered the domain name, and configure these two DNS servers so that your account will work. Now let's just keep this as a default, okay? There's no need to change this. And then we are going to click create to confirm and start creating the account. Okay, our account was just created successfully. This is very important for you to take note of this information. This information will be emailed to your customer, but it's very important that you take note and keep this info. Here you are, the domain name you just created, the username that he will use to access his cPanel and FTP or something, the password we just defined it, the quota, the DNS servers, or anything you may need. Okay, so this is it. The account is created. You're just ready to configure the DNS servers in the domain register for our customer, and the site is ready to be published. Okay, I hope you liked this video. And if you like it, just like us, you know, on YouTube. Okay, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.